it, get on.
I know that we'll have a ball.
If you're here to share on Saturday Night Live, she's also performed on HBO's Lucky Luke. Please give it up for this Elaine Williams.
I think a lot of times when you have that much power sort of thrust upon you at a very early age, I could see why addiction is sort of, it happens. And I think you have to have someone to help ground you, to help navigate the forces of everything that's coming at you.
I'm going to tell you, you're not alone. Or if you know somebody and love somebody who could be dealing with something, you're not alone. I felt alone for most of my life growing up with the people I did. And one of the greatest gifts of being sober is I have a whole fellowship of people to connect with who understand my thinking and sometimes my weird feelings.
See, my problem started. I grew up, my dad was a pharmacist and a dentist. So he wouldn't let us have any gum or candy, but we could have as much Vicodin and codeine as we wanted. So my family, we didn't have bedtime, we had last call.
I'm single, I've never been married, and I gotta say, I wouldn't marry me either. I can't sew, I can't cook. The last time I set foot in the kitchen was to light a joint off the stove.
But first I'm gonna tell you a little bit about my story. And once again, I want this to be interactive. If anybody has a question, a concern, a comment, raise your hand. I want this to be a safe space. We're going to be doing some cool sharing. So if you can get in pairs, if you want to participate with each other, that's great. Twos, or you guys could do a three-way.
Some people drink every day. Some people don't. It's not, and that was part of my denial, is I don't drink every day. Okay, 5 times a week, 4 times a week. It's what happens to you when you do drink. It's not necessarily the quantity. Which is tricky, because a lot of people hide behind that, well, I don't drink every day, or I don't drink in the morning, or I only drink it some mornings, you know.
But yeah, you know, here's the thing about a house, right? You're never done, right? You've always got something to fix or do or paint, so, and I'm always buying crap for my house. So I was in this candle store the other day, there was this candle that said, Memories from Home. But when I opened it, it didn't smell like cigars, scotch, and please don't touch me there.
One thing that put me over was my girlfriends would be like, oh my God, we drank so much last night, we forgot to pay our bar tab. I'd be like, that's all you got? Are you kidding? I drank so much last week and I woke up in Hong Kong handcuffed to a hooker.
And I also had to stop drinking because you know those like little two-word reasons like court order, dumpster sex, bearded midgets. It was time.
And you know they say alcoholism runs in families. Well, in mine, it ran the family. Like in school for emergency contact, I just put Sam Adams.
You know, I think college is such a paradox because you're here to learn and build and network and build your resume and study your undergrad and your grad and create your dream and your careers. At the same time, you want to have the social fun, right? You don't want to miss one or the other. So, you know, it's like if you get too into the party, you will totally screw up the other. So it's like finding the balance.
Because I used to drink a lot. Yeah, I'm actually 25, if you don't count the 10 years of blackout drinking right now. Which means I had entire relationships in a blackout, you know, kind of like a lot of marriages these days, right? And I love when people are like, oh, Elaine, do you remember the blackout of 2003 in New York? I'm like, you remember 2003?